might have just created the greatest game ever, but if you can't find a way to stand out, you might end up lost in a sea of forgotten projects. Thumbnails are little posters or title pages that advertise your Scratch project and make them stand out, which is pretty important when you consider that at last count, there were more than 123 million shared projects out there competing for your attention. By default, Scratch automatically creates these little images out of whatever was visible on your screen when you last saved your project. If you're looking for thumbnail ideas, you'll find plenty of great examples among the most popular Scratch projects. There are exceptions, but most great thumbnails contain three important elements. First, you'll need a single dominant image. You'll need to make this big so it looks good even when it's shrunk down to 200 pixels, which is Scratch's standard thumbnail width. The second thing you'll need is a nice, clean, uncluttered background. If you're going to use a background from your game, try zooming in so just the most important details are visible. Better yet, just use a plain color or gradient background. Lastly, you'll need a big, bold title with bright colors that are easily visible when shrunk. Unless you're an artist, don't try to draw your own font. Unless you actually want your thumbnail to look like it was crayon by a kindergartner wearing mittens. Scratch fonts are fine, but with only 6 fonts to choose from, it's hard to make something unique. If you want to really power up your thumbnail game, try using a font generator. Font generators are websites that let you type your own text and style it with hundreds of different fonts, outlines, shadows, and other cool special effects. You can then export your text as an image that you can bring into Scratch. There are lots of great font generators on the web, but these are some of my favorites. They all work a little differently, but they all have controls that let you play with colors and styles until you find something perfect. Make sure your final font image has a transparent checkerboard background. You'll want to export it as a .png format. Make sure to create your thumbnail as a sprite and not as a background, because you'll want to float it on top of your other game elements. A great coding trick for thumbnails is to put the sprite in a loop that will constantly bring it to the front of the screen. To make your sprite disappear when your game starts, use a when clicked hat block and make it fade away by increasing its ghost effect to 100. Your thumbnail will be invisible until you stop your project. The ghost effect is switched off, and there's your thumbnail again in all its glory.